Okay, and welcome to the fifth part of the tutorial of making a DFT code. So let's put the coding music on. And this time we are going to do reduction of k-points to irreducible preload zone. So I just realized that we are in a great hurry. We have already wasted 30 minutes of our time and we are nowhere near implementing the projector augmented wave approach that we are going to do. So PUBs, PIWs. So we have to keep on going. So let's just open a new file IPZ and just start coding. And I'll be cheating that much that I'll just here's how to make a Moncourse pack grid. So this is the Moncourse pack, and you can just Google it and just run this once and see that we really get a Moncourse pack grid. So we have 3x3x3 grid, and we extend it by, if you have defined some lattice constant, and then we have the reciprocal space lattice constant, and we are going to only do cubic unit cells. So reciprocal unit cell is also cubic, and we need to scale this with this lattice constant, and that's it. We have basically our k-point grid and we are ready to integrate. The wake would be one divided by the number of elements, so it would be nk cubed. But we want to implement symmetry, so let's get started. First we want to code loop over all symmetry operations. So flip over x axis, y axis, z axis, that's one. And then furthermore, we want to loop over all permutations of the axis. So loop over all permutations of this, and that's it. So first, let me define, label each point. So we go from 1 to nk cubed here, and reshape it to represent real vector. So now each point in space is uniquely defined. And if we want to flip over fx, we do it of course like this, with simple matrix algebra stuff or matrix manipulation stuff. And also y and z. Clock is running. Clock is running. So, and furthermore, we want to do the permutation. So, permute indices with this permutation p. And we want to gather this all this one array. And please don't do this at home, but I'll just concatenate the array here. And I first squeeze it to a row vector. Okay. Now we have lots of symmetry, lots of points, and the action of each symmetry operation to those points. So it might be that some of the points, of course, if we have map 1 and we map it to 10, then at some point we have 10 and we map it back to 1. So we have lots of rows here, which are sort of the same. So let's first sort rows of this sims. So here's the sorted rows, and then only pick the unique ones. So we'll get basically first sort this into this, and then pick unique ones, so we cancel this out. And that's what we are going to do here. And we have sort of reduced the number of symmetry operations, number of points quite a bit. So let's just see what this does. And so we have 48 columns, which represent all the 48 different symmetry operations, and we have 4 rows, which represent 4 unique points. So for example, we have this 14, 14, 14, this 14 is the center point, and on each symmetry operation, no matter what it is, the center point of course remains in center. So We need to know now how many times, how many unique points there is in each of these. So let's just call for each row. So let's loop over the rows of sim. And 10, let's look at how many unique items in this row there is. And let's gather them to weight here. I'm just gonna get this number. Okay. Are we doing something wrong here? Let's see. What is size? Seems. Four times 48. Why is size R available 1 to? That was just a typo. Okay, now we have calculated the weight. So here's the weight of the K point. So of course we have to divide this weight with the total number of K points. And this is the integration weight, you know. And these are all unique, these points, no matter which we pick. So let's pick just one. So let's pick the first row of the zooms. So now we have the indices, and furthermore, now we should reduce. So reduce K points with these indices. And I think we're done. So let's plot here with red, say, and then move on. Reduce the K points. And after reduction, let's paint with blue. And here's the weights and reduced K points, and we should be done. So let's see. Okay, so these are the four unique K points. Oops, sorry. So these are the four unique K points which are circled, and others can be obtained using symmetry operations if the symmetry of the Hamiltonian permits. Okay, thank you for listening, and prepare for the part 6, where we're going to do projector augmented wave approximation.